Praise God, hallelujah. Praise the living Jesus, hallelujah. Good afternoon, hallelujah. Good afternoon to everyone out there. I just want to say Jesus loves you. We love you as well, hallelujah. Keep loving yourselves, hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Blessed be the name of the God of our salvation, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Well, my name is Pastor Mrs. Eunice Sage of Jesus Power Assembly of All Nations. Hallelujah. This church is located at Dampo Station, number 15. Then the Monday 16th week. Amen. Just come and fellowship with us Wednesdays 7 to 8:30. We have our Bible studies Fridays 7 to 8:39. Depends on how the Spirit leads us. We have our healing and deliverance services. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And of course, every first Friday, amen, is our general all night, where we meet to destroy the powers of darkness in a glorious way. Hallelujah. Every first Friday, which we just did 2 days ago. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just had our all night a few days ago. It was awesome. It was wonderful. And every first Sunday, which is today, is our Holy Communion, where we take the flesh and the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The reasons why we are living today, the reason why we are Christians today. Hallelujah. Today, we took the bread and the flesh of Jesus Christ, the blood and the flesh of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Every Sunday. So come and participate with us. You are all invited in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. May God bless you all in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And every Tuesday, we have our counseling. If you want to see our papa, you have any issue, he's loaded to help you spiritually. Hallelujah. He's loaded to give you godly counsel, to counsel you and to tell you the next level and what you need to do for your breakthrough and for your uplifting in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And this coming Sunday, glory be to God, this coming Sunday is our women meeting day. This coming Sunday, amen. This coming Sunday, come and hear and come. I will be praying for every woman. Are you a woman? You want to see God's glory upon your life? Are you a woman? You want to see God opening doors that you never think or imagine in your life? Come this Sunday. Amen. This coming Sunday. This coming Sunday, which is the, I think on the 15th. On the 15th of this month. On the 15th of October 2017. This coming Sunday, 15th of October. Come and join the women in this church. I'm going to be praying for all the women. Come fasting. Our weapon in this church is fasting and prayer. Hallelujah. Every member of this church knows that. Our weapon here is fasting and prayer. On the 15th of October, this month, which is coming Sunday, every woman here will be prayed for. And we personally lay hands on all the women. I'm going to pray, break yokes from the lives of women. Break yokes, break powers that has been holding them bound. If you are single, come. No man is asking you for marriage. Please come. This meeting is for you. Hallelujah. It's called Operation for Uplifting. You are going to be lifted as a woman. Your life will never remain the same. Come this Sunday, 15th of October. Hallelujah. Begins from 11 o'clock to 1:30, 2 o'clock. This Sunday, just come. I'm going to be praying for all the women, going to be breaking yokes from their lives. And your life will be moved forward. So it doesn't matter. It's not about, I'm not a member of that church or I'm not. In heaven, there is no name in the church in heaven. So if you just need breakthrough, you need help, come this Sunday. If you are a woman, you need help. If you are a woman, your marriage is not going well. You don't understand why your marriage is the way it is. Just come this Sunday. Hallelujah. If you are a woman, things are just happening in your home. You don't understand. Just come. Hallelujah. And if you are single, you know, just come. You will see what God will do. After this meeting on Sunday, your God-given husband will locate you in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. God bless you. Every woman that will be watching me today, I pray that you make your way to Jesus Power Assembly of All Nations at number 15. Then the Monday 16th week. You cannot miss it. This church is just by Damport Station. Damport Station. Every bus, all the buses, you know, they land in Damport Station. Hallelujah. When you get down in Damport Station, It's just a stone throw from the station. Number 15, then the Monday 16 work. Number 15, then the Monday 16 work, 9,000 Ghent in Damport. You cannot miss it. Hallelujah. You can get our contact and call us if you miss your way or something, you want to know more, just get our contact and call us. Hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty. And you can always watch us on YouTube. Just tap Pastor Eunice Sage. You see us there on YouTube. You can watch us on Facebook, Messenger, WhatsApp, in all the medias. You can see us there. Hallelujah. And you will hear what you want to hear from there. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Once again, I'm with you. I'm with you to tell you God's mind. Hallelujah. You and I know we just have less than 3 months to go to end the year 2017. Hallelujah. Less than 3 months to end 2017. And I'm here to tell you the mind of God today. I say you are going to end well. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, you are ending well. You are ending in a Holy Ghost grand style. The power of God is going to descend upon you to end well. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I tell you today, among those that the enemy has kept in their coven, among those that the enemy has kept in their wicked, dark places, your name will not be found there in the name of Jesus. Your name will not be found in the coven of witches. You will not be meet for the enemy to celebrate this Christmas in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Your blood will be forbidden in the kingdom of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Your flesh will be forbidden in the kingdom of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray today and I decree over your lives. I declare over your lives that this October you will end it. November you will end it. December you will end it. And you will enter 2018 in the Holy Ghost grand style. Don't be listening to all these declarations because they are for you. You and I know that the enemy, the month of Embers, especially the month we are right now, October, November, December, accident happens anyhow. Things happen anyhow. Why? Because the enemy, Satan, witches, they need blood. They need blood. They need blood. And that blood, they want to get it by early means. I say today in the name of Jesus, your blood will not be found in the kingdom of darkness. Your blood will become acid for the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Your flesh will become a toxic in the mouth of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. You cannot be eaten up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say you will end well. You will not die, but you will live to declare the goodness of God. Hallelujah. Right now, as we are talking, they need blood, they need things to enhance themselves and their spiritual lives. A lot of people in the kingdom of darkness. That is why today, this message, you will listen to it very carefully. It is for you. Don't ignore this message. Don't ignore, so that you will not ignore life. Satan is not joking, but many Christians are joking. Many believers are playing. Many Christians are playing. Many Christians, they are just, you know, just going to church because they want to go to church. Many Christians, they are just doing their own things because they see others doing it. Many Christians, they are just, you know, but Satan is not joking. I declare today and I decree that your blood will become an acid in the camp of the enemy. No one can drink your blood. Your blood is undrinkable in the name of Jesus Christ. Shout amen to that. Hallelujah. So my topic for you today is the banner of God over your life is love. The banner of God over your life is love. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I see God destroying. I see God disappointing. I see God destabilizing, render powerless, useless. Every power, everyone that want to take your name to the witch's coven, that want to take your name to the kingdom of darkness for meat in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now, let us turn our Bible very quickly to the book of Job. Let's go very quickly to the book of Job. Job chapter 5. Hallelujah. Let's turn our Bible this moment to the book of Job. Job chapter 5. verse 12. Job 5:12. Job 5:12, I read. He disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot carry out their evil enterprises. The Lord disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that their hands will not carry out their evil enterprises against you or consigning you. Is that not a good news? So when I tell you that the banner of God over your life is love, you better believe it. Job chapter 5, verse 12. It says, he disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that they will not have hands to carry out their evil enterprises. Hallelujah. What does that mean to you and I? The Lord disappoint the devices. The device could be anything. It could be by any means. You are sleeping in the night, you don't know what is going on. You are walking on the street, you don't know what is going on. You just wake up in the day and begin to do your own things. You don't know what is going on. The enemies are everywhere. The enemies are everywhere. They want to make sure that you don't end December. They want to make sure that you don't see 2018. They want to make sure that your blood is required. That is why you see accident. Just one accident, a lot of people will die. Just one thing just happened, a lot of people will give their life for it. Why? It is not the what causes the accident. The thing is that Satan needed blood. Satan needed blood. And Satan has vowed every year. Many people don't get to the next year. That is why this message is very, very important for you. You will end this year, and you are going to get to the next year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So when you begin to hear me declaring over your life that your blood becomes an acid in the camp of the enemy, you better shout the loudest hallelujah and amen. When I say that your flesh, your body is a toxic for the enemy, you shout the loudest amen and hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of Job chapter 5 verse 12, he disappointed the devices of the crafty. So right now in the name of Jesus Christ, everyone that has been planning, they allow you to go through January to this time. And they said by the end of October or by November or December, even December 31st, just to enter on the 1st that you will die. I stand in the altar of God to agree with you that you will not die. God Almighty is going to disappoint them in the name of Jesus Christ. God Almighty is going to bring all their works to naught in the name of Jesus Christ. Everyone that is planning against you, that you will not end this year, that you will not enter 2018, I say the Lord God Almighty will disappoint them in the name of Jesus. He will render everything that they are using, anyhow they want to do it. That is why the Bible said the crafty, he disappointed the devices. Devices mean that is the way, the channel that which they get to you. That is the devices. The devices means how they are going to get to you. That's why you see some people, they leave their home, you know, two cars will just jump, everyone with that blood will be flowing on the ground. That is another device. Device by accident. You have device by food poisoning. There are some people, they are just planning now. Let him visit me, let her visit me, put this in the food, and the person died. That is a device. There is another device that somebody can shake your hand. After shaking your hand, he will take your glory. That is another device. Somebody can shake your hand and deposit something inside of you, and when the person gets home, you will not die. That is another device. There are a lot of devices you can never think of. So, but God is saying today in the book of Job chapter 5 verse 12, so whichever devices they are going to use, it doesn't matter. Hallelujah. God said he will disappoint them. How will it happen? Let them gather and speak the word. Let them begin to plan about all those things. God said he will disappoint them. In other words, he will never allow them to come near your dwelling in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I say your name is removed from the book of death for this year. Your name, you that is watching me right now, you that is listening to me right now, I'm prepared for you. Hallelujah. I prepare today to come and tell you what God asked me to tell you. Amen. Because we are almost ending the year, and Satan is jubilating. Satan is planning every kind of devices. That is why Job chapter 5 verse 12 is for you. Job chapter 5 verse 12 is for you. He said the Lord disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that they will not have hands to carry out their evil enterprises. So that they will not have hands to carry out their evil enterprises. They will not have hands to carry out their evil plan against you. I said the Lord God Almighty is disappointing them today. All the plans of the enemy concerning your life, all the plans of the enemy concerning your destiny, all the plans of the enemy concerning your life to kill you or to render your life useless, the Lord God Almighty disappoint all their evil works today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Let us take it now to verse 13. Hallelujah. We are reading Job chapter 5, verse 12. We are reading 12 to 19. He disappointed the devices of the crafty so that their hands cannot perform their evil enterprises. Hallelujah. For example, somebody is just planning to do you harm. He's calling your name in one evil pot. He took your picture. Your picture is there. Your name is there. He took them. He's calling. And all of a sudden, as he wants to start, he has not started, but he arranged everything. You know one thing about this God? He will allow them to use all their resources. He will allow the enemy to gather. He will allow them, because before they gather, it costs them a lot of things. It costs them a lot. So God will allow them to spend. God will allow them to use all their strength, all their resources. Whatever they will go for, God will allow it. So as they gather, your picture is there. Your name is there. The moment they want to start, God said he will disappoint them by that hand. That a person that does not have a hand or does not have eye or does not have, if you don't have eye to see what you are doing, are you still going to continue? The moment they want to start, their eyes will be blind. Let us read it together. He disappointed the devices of the crafty so that their hands cannot perform their evil enterprises. The moment they want to stand and their two eyes are blind. They are not looking for where your picture is. They can't find it. Because their eyes are blind. He disappointed. That's the disappointment God is talking about. He disappointed the devices. So the device that they wanted to use to kill you, maybe it was the one, your picture, your photo, pulling it in a concussion, you know, or however, whatever, God will disappoint them in the name of Jesus Christ. Now let's go down to verse 13. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the froward is carried headlong. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness. So those that think that they are wiser than you, those that think that they know more than you, those that think that they are more intelligent more than you, those that think that they know the works of darkness more than you. Hallelujah. You are a Christian. You don't know what is going on. You are just doing your own thing, just following God. You are just doing your own things on a daily basis. And those people that think that they know more than you, in most cases, the people in the kingdom of darkness, they are always thinking they are more wiser. They think they know more. That is why you see they don't respect. The people in the kingdom of darkness, the people in the occult, the people in all these kind of stupid places, they don't respect. The marine kingdoms, people that are, you know, doing magics, people that are doing all kind of nonsense, they don't respect. You know, they are always very proud. Why? Because they believe that they've got the world in their hands, which is a very, very big lie. Hallelujah. Job chapter 5, verse 12 has already proved it all. God said he disappointed the devices of the crafty so that they will not have hand to carry out their evil enterprises. And verse 13 said, God Almighty, you know, take them, destroy them in their own craftiness. They think that they are wise enough. That is why when they come to you with boldness, they will just come to you with boldness. One agent of darkness, one witch, one wizard from somewhere, because of the magical power that is backing on, or he's trusting on, he will talk anyhow, you know, because they think that they are wiser than you. They think that they know what you don't know. Hallelujah. So God said, such people, when they are around you, such people, when they are even far from you, and they are thinking of destroying you, God said, in their own craftiness, he's going to do something terrible to them. Hallelujah. Verse 14, they meet with darkness in the daytime and group in the noontime as in the night. But you see how the darkness, you see how they work. They meet with darkness in the daytime and group in the noontime as in the night. Now let's take that to verse 16. So the poor had hope. Who are the poor? The poor that God is talking about here is not those who don't have money, physical money. No. It's not those who don't have things. No. This is a spiritual thing. The poor have hope. Job chapter 5, verse 16. The poor has hope. In other words, as a believer, as a Christian, just continue following God.
Just continue doing the things God wants you to do. Just continue loving Him and obeying Him. Just continue going to church. Just continue giving. Just continue sowing. Just continue listening to the Word of God. Not all these things that people are sitting on the media to talk about Christianity or to talk about the things of God. Those who are not in the kingdom, I don't know what concerns them with the things of the kingdom. Amen. People sit in the media to talk all kinds of things and all kinds of nonsense. Hallelujah. So we are not into all that. As a Christian, God is talking about here. He said, the poor are saved. So when people are talking against you, that's why the Bible says that when you are poor in the spirit, those that are poor in the spirit, they will inherit the kingdom of God. It's not poverty, talking of physical money, no. Those that are poor in the spirit, they will inherit the kingdom of God. So in other words, I swear, God said that the poor, they hope. The poor, they have hope. The poor, they have hope. So as a Christian, people are just, you know, thinking that they can destroy you just like that. People think that they can sit in the media to talk against you. People think that they can take your name everywhere and begin to scandalize you. People think that they can do one thing or the other in order to spoil you. I said it in one of my messages. Those that are spoiling you, they are not spoiling you, but they are spoiling the God that you carry. Hallelujah. Apostle Paul said, he said, the life I live now, I live it for Christ. Nevertheless, I live. But the life that I live now, I live it for Christ. Hallelujah. So, the poor have hope. Let me tell you, my brothers and my sister out there, you know, just keep doing the good things that you know how to do. Follow God with all your heart. Love Him with all your mind. Love Him with all your soul. Don't allow the things you are hearing now on media, in the Facebook, in wherever, to distract you from the God that you have given your life to right from the beginning, from the God that you are following. Study your Bible, read your Bible, and you will see that God is the God of all flesh. He is the one that is watching over you. That's why I say the banner of God over your life is love. So don't allow anybody to talk you out of Christianity. Don't allow anybody to talk you out of this God. Don't allow anybody to discourage you from the commandment of God. It's better you obey God rather than man. What can man do for you? The Bible says the poor has hope. The Bible says you have hope. There is hope for you. There is hope for you. God is the one that is giving you that hope. He's not man. What I have found out now is that a lot of people, they are out of track. A lot of people, they are out of line. A lot of people, they are out of the way of Christianity. A lot of people, they are just concerned. They are just like this. So what do? They are looking for as many people that will fall the way they did. They are looking for as many people that will go down the way they did. They are looking for as many people to follow their own way because they don't want to go to hell alone. So it doesn't matter who is talking in the media. It doesn't matter who is talking in the church. It doesn't matter who is talking. I want to encourage you, my brothers, my sisters, whatever you have learned that you have learned in the Word of God, stay by it. Stay by the Word of God. Stay by the commandment of God. When God said, do this, do it. When God said, pay your tithe, pay your tithe. When God said, give offering, give offering. When God said, come to church, come to church. When God said, take care of people, take care of people. When God said, love, love. When God said, whatever God gives you to do, do it. Don't follow the commandment of men. Don't follow the commandment of people. Whatever is in the Word of God that you have been taught right from beginning, that you have been walking with, my brothers, my sisters, stay by it and let the Word of God show you the way. Let the Word of God show you the way. Let the Word of God be your light. Let the Word of God be the one that is channeling your life. Hallelujah. God says here that there is hope for you. He said the poor have hope. In other words, you that they are spoiling, you that they are scandalizing, you that they are saying that, oh, you are going to fall, you are not going to rise, you are not going to make it because in their kingdom, they think that they have all what it takes. So right now, God is telling you that you have hope. You have hope. Hallelujah. The banner of God over your life is love. The banner of God over your life is love. When you do what God asks you to do, when you study your Bible, I always encourage people, please study your Bible for yourself. Study your Bible for yourself. If whatever anybody tells you is not biblical, and don't follow those that will twist the Bible for you, that will turn the Bible upside down. Don't follow those that will use their own minds to explain the Bible to you. No one can understand the scripture unless by the Spirit of God. You need the Holy Spirit to understand the scripture. You need the Holy Ghost to understand the scripture. Don't follow those that are just reading the scripture just as for reading say, just as the way they read literature and they passed literature. Just the way they read English books and they passed English. Bible is more than that. The word of God is more than that. The word of God is deep and deep and deep. The word of God needs the Spirit of God to understand it. Hallelujah. The word of God needs the Spirit of God to understand it. So don't just believe everything you are hearing in the media concerning Christianity, concerning the church of God, concerning the servants of God. Don't believe everything you are hearing. Study God's word for yourself. Study the things of God for yourself. And you will know that there is hope for you. And you will land in the Holy Ghost grand star. Hallelujah. I will not forget my topic. I will not like to digress. I will not forget because I'm just seeing in the media, many people are just saying all kinds of things about tithing, about offering, about... Is that the issue of the time now? Is that the issue of the time? That is not the issue. Hallelujah. That is not the issue. There are a lot of things going on right now in the world. People are not... Salvation is very far from people. So go to the media and talk about salvation, not about tithing. Tithing is allowed in the kingdom of God. That is the only way. I will prove light of that. Tithing is the only way. If you want to go above your mate in life, if you want to achieve in life, and of course, it's another way of pleasing God. It's another way of pleasing God. We don't have time for that. Hallelujah. We don't have time to go into that. That is not my message. As a Christian, if you are not tithing, number one, you have disobeyed God. And number two, you cannot, miracle don't fall on people. Finance, there is no prayer of financial breakthrough. There is nothing like financial breakthrough. When you pray for financial breakthrough, you will break through today, tomorrow you will break down. You will break through today, tomorrow you will break down. But what keeps it going is your covenant keeping with God. When you keep your covenant with God, you give your tithe. He said, bring your tithe to the storehouse. Bring your tithe. Bring your tithe. Bring your tithe. Bring your tithe. You don't even talk about that. You don't even compromise that. It's not something that one even need to talk about. It is because the Holy Spirit is not involved. That is why. When you have the Holy Spirit, you don't add to the things of God. You don't add to the things of God. It's mind-blowing when I see people are talking about this in the media. When I see the people that are talking about this in the media, it was mind-blowing. Hallelujah. So don't follow what you hear. Follow the system of God. Follow the system. Read your Bible for yourself. We are in the last days. We are in the last days where many people, they are falling there and they are looking for those that will fall along with them. You know, don't let anyone take you off track. Don't let anyone take you off track. God said he will disappoint the devices of the crafty. Your obedience to God's word is what will make God fight your battle for you. God cannot just be fighting for those that goes off track. Hallelujah. So if you want this prayer to be for you, walk according to the purpose of God upon your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do what God asks you to do and not what man asks you to do. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Now quickly, let's go to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 8. The book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 8, verse 10. Isaiah chapter 8, verse 10. Isaiah 8, verse 10. Take counsel together, and it shall come to naught. Speak the word, and it shall not stand, for God is with us. Ha! Did you see the reason why I said the banner of God over your life is love? God loves you so much. God loves you so much, and God also expects you to obey him. He said, take counsel together. Ha! Isaiah chapter 8 verse 10, where we have just read. Isaiah 8 verse 10. He said, let them take counsel together. What does that mean? Let them gather together. Let them speak the word. God said it will come to naught. Naught. Not zero. Zero is like this. But naught is that one you do like this, and you put another one, bam, inside. That dot. Zero is even better than not. Zero, like this. You count zero, then before you put it, one, two, three. But this one says to not. After drawing that zero, you put stop. Bah, that's not. Let your enemies gather. Let them speak the word. Let them take your photo. I am praying for everyone today because the year is coming to an end. This is the time Satan needs blood in their kingdom. This is the time witches, they need blood in their covens. This is the time that they are not very effective because they need blood. They need blood at this time. October, November, December. That is why you see fighter accidents this time. Everywhere. Everywhere. Things are happening everywhere. There are accidents on the normal days, but when it comes to September, October, November, December, especially from this time forward now, from this time onward, blood everywhere. And people will say, ah, but... When you see that, don't think of how it happened. Craftiness, that's what we read in the book of Job. They come in any way. In any way they come. What they don't need is that blood. Anyhow they do it, it doesn't matter to them. So that's why God said he disappointed the devices. So whichever device that they use, don't try to reason it out. A lot of accidents everywhere, people try to reason. How did this accident just happen? Don't try to reason it because you can never get the reason. It is a spiritual thing. What the kingdom of darkness needs is just blood. Blood for more power to carry on to the next year. I said that God disappointed them today in the name of Jesus. The God of my salvation disappointed. He disappointed them and he destroyed them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Look at what Isaiah chapter 8 verse 10 is saying. He said, let them gather together. Let them take counsel together. In other words, they are gathered all because of you. They are just speaking all because of you. They are making their plans all because of you. God said he will call them to naught. He will call them to naught. You are not the one to compare. God himself. He said he will call them to naught. Hallelujah. He will bring you out safely. He will bring you out safely. He will deliver you safely because he is always with you. Hallelujah. You can see, you can only do that for someone you love. You can only do that for someone you love. I want to tell everybody today, God loves you so much. He loves you so much. Don't allow anybody to talk you out of this world. God loves you so much. I know what I'm saying. He loves you so much. Do you know what it means? Isaiah chapter 8 verse 10. Let them take counsel. Let them speak the word. God said, he said, he will call them to naught. So, when you see some people, a lot of people, I see all your enemies be frustrated today. I see those that does not want you to see 2018, I see them be frustrated. The Lord is frustrating all their efforts. Any effort they made, the Lord will frustrate them. If they make any effort to poison you by food, the Lord will frustrate them. If any enemy make effort to kill you by accident, the Lord will frustrate them. If the enemy make effort for you to sleep, not to wake up, God will frustrate them. If the enemy plan for you to visit them and they put something by their door, so that when you cross that thing, you will fall down and die. I say, God will frustrate them in the name of Jesus. He frustrated the counsel of the enemy. He frustrated them so that they will not have how to carry out their evil enterprises. Anyhow they want to get to you this year, I'm talking to you. You that is watching me right now. Anyhow the enemy want to get to you to kill you so that you will not see December. You will not see the end of December. I say the Lord is frustrating them today in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord is frustrating them today. The Lord is disappointing them today. The Lord is destroying them today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He disappointed the devices of the crafty. There are some people, they are into your life, they are like a snake. They are like this. In your front, they are good to you. But in your back, they become your enemy. In your front, they are good to you. So in your back, they become your enemy. They are the one that take your name to the enemy. They are the one that say, look, you see, December is coming. It's my best friend. She's my best friend. You know, she will be the one. Don't worry, I will bring her. I will bring her. She will be the one to be meet. He will be the one to be meet that we use to celebrate this Christmas. I say the blood of Jesus Christ, the fire of the Holy Ghost is arresting them, every enemy of your progress. Every enemy that you do not know, every enemy that comes as a friend to you, that want to take your picture, or that has already taken your picture, or your name to the witch's coven, in order to destroy you, in order to kill you before the end of December, so that you will not see the end of the end of 2017, so that you will not enter 2018. I say today, the Lord God Almighty is frustrating them. The Lord God Almighty is calling their works to naught in the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord God of our salvation is calling their works to naught in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let them gather. Isaiah 8:10. Let them take counsel. It shall come to naught. It shall not stand. It shall not stand. It shall not stand. All of a sudden, you can just see some people, they will just hate you for nothing. Why? You don't know why. Because they have taken your name to the witch's coven. They have done all kinds of things. When they want to come this way, the Lord will disappoint them. When they want to come into your life through the other way, the Lord will disappoint them. When they want to destroy you through enemies, the Lord will disappoint them. When they take your name to the witch's coven, that coven will catch fire. When they take your name to the Marie Kingdom, that Marie Kingdom will be shaking. When they take your name to when they cause an accident because of you, they will be surprised that that car, he almost have an accident. Almost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They will, because of you, cause an accident in the car. The God of our salvation that neither sleep nor slumber. The God that goes with his children anywhere they go. The God that does not close his eye will divert that accident. Ha! He will divert that accident. So you see some car, you see that car almost have an accident. Almost, but he didn't have an accident. Hallelujah. God has a way of being with his children, taking care of his children, bringing them and delivering them from all troubles. Hallelujah. Let them gather, let them speak the word. God said he will bring it to naught. It will not come to pass. Hallelujah, because he's always with you. Now, lastly, right now, let's go to the book of Psalm 33. Let's go to the book of Psalm 33. Let's go very quickly to Psalm 33, verse 10. The Lord bringeth the counsel of the heathen to naught. He maketh the devices of the people of none effect. He maketh the devices of the people of none effect. Ha! I say every device. You see, all the scripture we are reading since is just talking of device. Device. The enemy, they have their device. Device means the channel at which the enemy gets to you. Device simply means the way they get to you. They don't get to everybody by one device. They don't get to everybody by one means. That's why I've been explaining. Some, they make truth food poison. They put something in the food. That is another. There is one device. One of the devices. Food poison. They put food. They put poison in the food for you to eat. After eating that food, you die. That is one device. Another device. They come in the night to come and invade your home spiritually. That's another device. Another device. They cause accidents. They cause accidents. That any car the person enter, that car will have accident. That's why you see many buses and all these things that are having accidents somewhere. You know, it's not because of all the people there. It's just because of one person. They just want the blood of one person. So it happens that other people take that same bus, so they become a victim. That is another device. And they come through shaking of hands. You're not surprised somebody shake your hand. Maybe your manhood is gone, or something leave you. If you're a woman, maybe your breast is gone, or something just leave you by shaking of hands. That is another device. There are so many, you can name them all. They don't come in one device. So that's why you see all the scriptures we are reading since. We have read Job, we have read Psalm, we have read Isaiah. Every device is Job chapter 5 verse 12. He said, he disappointed the devices of the crafty so that they will not have hand to carry out their evil enterprises. Hallelujah. Now we have just read now Isaiah chapter 8 verse 10. He said, let them take counsel. Let them gather. God Almighty said, he'll call it to naught. He'll call it to naught. Now, we have just read now in Psalm chapter 33, verse 10. It says, he make the devices of the enemy of none effect. I say, no matter how they plan against you, it will not affect you in the name of Jesus. No matter how they plan against you this year, for you not to end this year, I say it will not work in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I see God scattering. Scatter in the name of Jesus. Every devices, every plan, whichever way they come, whichever way they plan it, I see God destroy them in the name of Jesus Christ. I see God render it powerless and useless like that of an Ahithophel in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I see God taking you out of every trouble. I see God taking you out of every bad situation this year in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I see God helping you to arrive. Hallelujah. I see God making you, helping you, joining you, supporting you. Hallelujah. To end this year, December. To end this year. We are now in October. You will end October. You will end November. You will end December. And you will enter January to December 2018. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every accident arrangement return back to sender. Any device that the enemy used to arrange against you, I return it back to sender. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Lord God Almighty is with you as a mighty, terrible one. Hallelujah. Just cheer up every day in the name of Jesus Christ as a child of God. God said he's with you. He's with you to deliver you. He's with you to help you. He's with you to help you, to heal you. He's with you to bring you out of every trouble. He said, many are the afflictions of the righteous. The Lord God Almighty delivers them. Ah! I see God delivering you today from every kind of trouble. It doesn't matter, be it big, small, medium. I see God delivering you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. I say you are blessed and highly favored. Fear not. Everyone watching me, this broadcast today is highly anointed for everyone that wants to see the end of the year. And of course, want to enter 2018 and end also 2018 in the name of Jesus Christ. I prepare to come to your way today in the name of Jesus Christ. The anointing of God is upon me, and he has anointed me to preach liberty, to preach freedom to those who are oppressed. So I don't care whatever is happening to you, or whatever has been happening to you, or whatever nightmare you have been having up till now. You are already scared that you will not see the end of the year because of the kind of nightmare, bad dreams you are having. You are already scared because of what is happening in your family. Every December, somebody must die. Or every November or every October, you think it's now your turn. Today, in the name of Jesus Christ, standing on the word of God, the Lord God Almighty disappoint all their devices in the name of Jesus. I say you will not die. You will testify. You will testify. You will testify to the glory of God. Anywhere you are, all over the world, you are in America, you are in Asia, you are in Africa, you are in Europe, anywhere you are, it doesn't matter. Distance is not a barrier. We are serving the living God. Holy Spirit is omnipresent, is omnipotent. He's everywhere at the same time. Jesus is omnipotent, omnipresent, he's everywhere at the same time. Hallelujah. So he is the one that will do what no one can do for you, and he's already doing it in the name of Jesus Christ. I say you will not die. You will live to declare the goodness of God in the land of the living. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Shalom. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you. Like I told you, watch us on YouTube. We are on YouTube. Watch us every time. Watch us always. Don't be tired. Share. Hallelujah. Share. Subscribe to us. You can imagine you are subscribing to this kind of anointing. It will work for you. Hallelujah. Share messages. Share this message to friends. There are a lot of people who are afraid now because of the dreams in your family, among your friends, among the people you love, who are already afraid because of the bad dreams that they had. They are already afraid, panicking, thinking, oh, they are not going to get to this here because they have gone to warn them in the dream. Share this message for them. Please save somebody's life. Save somebody's life. Save somebody's life by sharing this. Let them hear, because that is the truth. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. Hallelujah. Give hope to somebody by sharing, and you'll be blessed and highly favored by God in Jesus' mighty name. See you on Wednesday on Bible study. God bless you. If you are close to here, see you on Wednesday. If you are not close to this place, we'll see you always every Sunday. God bless you. Shalom.